Here I'll show you a technique for creating scrolling games. To start off my scrolling game, I've created foregrounds. I've called them screen 0, screen 1, screen 2, and screen 3. Here I've clicked on screen 0, and I can zoom out all the way, and I've painted a floor, and here it's blue with orangish polka dots. And as the character walks to the right, this blue platform will move to the left, and that way it'll look like the world is moving to the left. Although if I move this platform to the left, eventually it'll be off the screen. So I need another platform lined up right behind it. So I'll start with screen 0 and have a blue one, then I'll have a green one, then a purple one, and then a yellow one. I want to line up these platforms one after the other. Let's look at how we do that. Let's look at the script for screen 0. Here it says, when the green flag is clicked, forever go to X, scroll amount plus 0, and y equals 0. So when I start, scroll amount is 0, and I go to 0, 0. It seems like that would put it in the middle of the stage. But if I look at the costume, I can see that the center is right there. That's what will go to 0, 0. And the blue line, that'll go on the bottom. Okay, so I put it to 0, 0. Where do I put the next one? I need to put it 480 pixels to the right, because the whole stage is 480 pixels wide. So I put it at scroll amount plus 480. I bet you can guess where the purple one goes. It needs to go another 480 degrees to the right. So we put it at scroll amount plus 480 times 2. Similarly, the yellow one needs to go another 480 pixels to the right. So we put it at scroll amount plus 480 times 3. Let's go back to the green one. As we move the character to the right, scroll amount will become a negative number. Each time we press the right key, scroll amount will decrease by 10. So after pressing the right key 48 times, scroll amount will actually be negative 480. And that'll make this green platform be exactly in the center of the stage. I'll zoom out and look at the scripts for the cat. When the left arrow key is pressed, I'm going to switch to costume, walk left. That'll show the cat walking left. And then I'll change the scroll amount by 10. So when I walk to the left, scroll amount increases. When the right arrow key is pressed, I'll switch to costume, walk right, and change the scroll amount by negative 10. Remember, that will move all of my platforms to the left. Check it out. When I'm doing this, watch how scroll amount changes. I'll click the green flag. Negative 30, negative 40, negative 50, negative 60, negative 70. It keeps increasing. And we can start to see the green platform. If we click on the green platform, you can see it's now at X is 270, and that's just scroll amount, which is negative 210 plus 480, or 480 minus 210 is 270. So that's where it is. As I keep going to the right, scroll amount keeps decreasing, and I see my green platform, eventually my purple platform, and finally my yellow platform. If I walk back to the left, scroll amount will increase, and eventually I'll get back to my green platform. And finally, my blue platform. And when scroll amount is 0, that's when the blue platform is right in the center. Just like when scroll amount was 480, the green platform would be right in the center. See? In this version, when I move to the left or the right, the cat always stays exactly in the center. You might try this next part if you want the cat to be able to move around, and only when they walk towards the far right does it scroll, or the far left does it scroll. To do this, I'll use an if-else. If the exposition is greater than negative 100, then if I press the left arrow key, I'll actually move it to the left. If the exposition is equal to negative 100 or less than negative 100, then he's already gone too far to the left, and I should just change the scroll amount. So I'll take this and put it in here. And to make sure he doesn't go past the x position of negative 100, I'll set the x position here to negative 100. I can do the same thing for the script on the right. If the X position is less than 100, then he's not on the far right, and I can just move him around. If his X position is greater than or equal to 100, then I want to change the scroll amount by negative 10, and I'll set his X to 100. I'll start back at the beginning and then show you how this works. So scroll amount starts at 0. If I move to the right a little, it doesn't change scroll amount. Only when my character gets to X equals 100 does it start scrolling. And if I turn around, I can move around, but it doesn't change the platform. And only if I get to an X position of negative 100 will it scroll back to the left. Cool, huh? I think this can make the game a little bit more fun because the cat can move around the screen a bit.